Vice President Lenny Robredo calls for a timeout amid the political bickering over the distribution of lockdown in Metro Manila. Some lawmakers have expressed dismay after President Rodrigo Duterte slammed an unnamed local official for supposedly being disorganized amid the pandemic. For her take on this issue, we have former Social Welfare Secretary Judy Taguiwalo. She's currently the spokesperson of Cure COVID-19. Good morning, Ma'am Judy. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Nikki.
Okay, so before we get to that, first off, Metro Manila residents affected by the second round of the ECQ in 2021 have just begun receiving supplemental aid yesterday. As a former DSWD, how is it going so far? Which cities do you think have been handling it best? Which have been handling it rough?
Well, I can just depend also on your reportage. Generally, all the cities have started their payout. I think for some, there have been 5,000 families served. So times five, that would be, it's very far from the target, 11 million. We're looking at 15 days, no, to complete the payout. And that is problematic, Nikki, because the financial assistance is very much needed, and it has been very much needed a long time before this ECQ. As early as April and May, we have already asked for the passage of Bayanihan 3 because hunger rates have gone up, and you have seen the line for the community pantries, no? And so many are jobless. So even before the ECQ, we needed that money. Okay.
And you know, last Monday, President Duterte said he would order the removal of an LGU, which the public actually alludes to Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, and the NCR distribution of cash aid during the ECQ, directing it to the DILG and DSWD to take over. But you've since said the DSWD is already burdened with other social protection programs, such as the 4Ps, social pension, and assistance to persons in crisis. How would asking them to take on the direct distribution of cash aid in LGU impact the aid distributions?
As a DSWD secretary, I have long seen the importance of collaboration between the national agency and the LGUs. The LGUs are the frontliners. We provide technical assistance. If needed, we support them with the personnel. But the end of the day, the much needed operations would be done by the local government units because they know the communities. They know how the people are. Now, asking an LGU, removing that responsibility of the LGU would only mean delay in the payout. And we don't want that because we're looking at, you know, people who are hungry, people who needed help. And well, I think the point is not to politicize it because so much is needed to be done. What is that? The ayuda is delayed. The ayuda is insufficient. The ayuda does not cover everyone. We're talking of the homeless here. They're not in the list. How can they be assisted? Because if you're not in the list of the local government units, then you cannot receive the amount. And the 1,000 to 4,000 pesos assistance won't be sufficient given how long we have been under lockdown. So we're asking the president focus on making the pandemic response comprehensive, make the response effective. It is a health and economic crisis. It is not a military crisis. We're not talking about, you know, pasaway here. We're talking about the lack of economic support, the lack of vaccines, the lack of assistance to so many vulnerable sectors. So stop attacking political opponents. I think the last survey showed that 9 out of 10 Filipinos felt that the response to the pandemic has been inadequate. I think that should be the message sent to the president.
All right. Ma'am Judy, you've since also, as you said, deplored the quote, politicization of the ayuda distribution in Metro Manila. The president singled out just one city when actually several LGUs, namely Las Piñas, Manila, and Quezon City, all saw larger crowds than expected flocking to vaccination sites last August 5. This confusion also comes just a day before Metro Manila cities began the distribution of the cash assistance. So how much of our government's COVID response is affected by the politics surrounding the 2022 elections? Do you think the government prioritizes enough the aid distribution efforts amid the ECQ?
Well, we don't want that to happen. I think walang puso ka ngayon in the midst of so much, you know, suffering, so much death, looking at the upsurge, you know, of the admissions in the hospitals, the pila of people needing emergency assistance, and you think about politicizing it, attacking your enemies, spreading fake information. It is inhumane. It is inhumane. It should not be the focus. It should not have been the focus ever since. The focus should have been grappling with the health an economic crisis and providing the needed assistance. Mass testing, we're talking about testing here, it's below 50,000 yesterday. We're talking about here contact tracing. Contact tracing is so important, less than 50,000. We're talking about here of free testing. So I think all this political thing should be put behind us, no? We should call out our officials to say, tama na, sobra na. Kung hindi mo kaya, ibigay mo nyo na sa iba.
And that, Ma'am Judy, we know handling distribution to national government agencies doesn't always spell efficiency either. As former DSWD secretary, you know it was also hit by local government units last year and lawmakers for delays in distributing cash aid to beneficiaries. But would you say that the situation now, more than a year in, is more manageable and is being handled more efficiently?
The problem is not just a question of bureaucracy, it's a question of trust because it is targeted financial assistance. So you need so many like right now, you have to have an ID, you have three copies of the ID. So how about those who don't have the money to have this ID photocopied? It is bureaucratic because it is targeted. There is inclusion, exclusion. So from the beginning, we have said there should be universal assistance because this pandemic has affected all of us. Bayanihan 3 actually responded to that. In terms of the actual payout, it can be overwhelming because now it is face to face. They're saying we can do it over cash payments, but there has been problems about the financial partners of DSWD. I think Senator Pacquiao has pointed out how come this one agency has gotten this huge contract, and four other well-known payout agencies like PayMaya, GCash have backed out from being involved in the payout. So there is also lack of transparency. All in all this leads to inefficient payout. But the main source of inefficiency is its inability to provide financial assistance already prior to the pandemic, prior to the SEQ, as early as April or May. And now we're talking 63 billion pesos. The amount of the Bayanihan to unspent funds. So you see, Nikki, yes, there is inefficiency, there is delay in the payout, but these are only symptomatic of the overall incompetence in preparing for the gravity, no, for the seriousness, not just preparing, in addressing the gravity and seriousness of the pandemic, not only because of the ECQ, but because you have been here for over 1 year.
All right, so we're gonna have to leave it at that.
But we
please
need
continue.
We need to pass additional ayuda. This one is just temporary and we're going to restate it. This is not handout. When you give people money during the pandemic, it is not handout. It helps the economy recover because people have money to spend. So we should look at it, because always, even ANC has shown somebody, we cannot give additional handout because it will affect our credit ratings. I hope you will have a chance to discuss this between credit ratings and the need of our people.
All right, we're gonna have to leave it at that. Thank you so much for joining us, Ma'am Judy Taguiwalo. You stay safe.